Hi.
Hi. Today I'll be discussing DC motors. DC motors is essentially practically the same as DC generators. The main difference of DC motors is that on your DC generators, you convert mechanical energy to electrical energy. For DC motors, it takes an electrical input, electrical power, and converts it into a mechanical output or mechanical power. Therefore, instead of voltage and current at the output, your DC motors have torque and RPM at the output. Instead of taking in torque and RPM in the input, your DC motors take in voltage and current. It's basically opposite the DC generators in terms of operation. Now, since your DC motors is practically the same as DC generators, you'll be expecting the same equivalent circuit. You have the same DC motor types. You have separately excited DC motors, shunt motor. Where is that? Series motor, series DC motor. It's the same. It's the same configuration as your series DC generator. Your shunt generator is this one. Yeah. Sorry. Your shunt motor is this one. Same configuration as shunt generator. And then you also have compound or combination of series and shunt. Now the main difference of in terms of equivalent circuit, the main difference of your motor and generator is that instead of your current going out, you have this terminal. You have this terminal and then you have that voltage at the terminal. Now, instead of the current going out, your current for motors goes in because it is taking an electrical power as an input. So what happens here is you have the input here at the terminals instead of the output for motors. For generators, you have the output at the terminals, but for motors, you have the input at the terminals. Then you subtract the power at the power loss, electrical losses, and now you have the power at the armature or the power developed at the armature. Now this is the configuration for your separate excited. You have a separate field here, but I guess the important I want to highlight the direction of the current here. So again, for motors, your current goes to the machine, to the armature. For generators, your current goes out of the armature. That goes the same for the different configurations. Let's see, you have the shunt. You have the separately excited generator, your line current. In this case, we'll be using the term line current instead of load current because we are taking the current as the input. So the line current is at the terminal going into the armature. You have a separate excitation, therefore you have a separate field here supplied by a separate source voltage. Now the working equations would be different because in this case your KBL terminal voltage will be equal to EA plus the voltage drop at the copper. Now this is different for generators because for generators your EA is greater than VT, making the KVL VT equals EA minus the voltage drop at the armature. Now for shunt, you have this. Again, the difference of motor and generator is that for motors, your current comes from the line, then it goes to the armature and the field. This is opposite the generator because for generators you have the current at the armature, which is equal to your current at the field and the current at the load. So the load for motors is somewhere here. Well, this is just p-developed, so you subtract the mechanical losses, you get the power output. I'll go to the power flow of motors later. Then you have the series machine, series motors, this one, it goes from the load to the armature. Now, in terms of power flow, where is that? In terms of power flow, you take an electrical input. You take an electrical input to produce, sorry, this should be P out. This one should be P out, an electrical, a mechanical output. So your electrical input is in terms of voltage and current, your mechanical output is in terms of torque and omega. From your electrical input, you reduce the electrical losses, you get the power at the armature. This is where your power is directly convertible between electrical and mechanical. So your electrical power at the armature is equal to your mechanical power at the shaft. Now, for the shaft. Now, from your mechanical power, you reduce all of the mechanical losses, then you get the mechanical output. So in terms of efficiency, you have the input, electrical input, and then the mechanical output over input, that gives you an efficiency. So the overall output divided by the overall input gives you the commercial efficiency or the machine efficiency. Now if you divide the output with the P convert, so that is basically the efficiency after the mechanical losses, so that is mechanical efficiency. So if you take P convert divided by P input, that is basically the efficiency after the electrical losses, so that is electrical efficiency. So I discussed the different types of losses before on the previous video on DC generators. If you want, you may check that video for the discussion. I guess, yeah, this is the efficiencies. Now, instead of voltage regulation, you want to regulate the speed of a motor because that's the output. So for generators, you have voltage regulation because that's the output. For motors, you have speed regulation because that's the output. Now, speed regulation is just no load minus full load divided by full load. It's the same as generators, but instead of voltage, you have speed, RPM or RPS. So I guess this gives you an idea that the speed of a motor differs according to its loading. So if it's not loaded, it runs faster than if it's fully loaded. So for the voltage EA, the derivation of this, I believe, is still at DC generators video. So again, you may check on that video for the derivation of this, for the explanation of the variables. Then armature torque, it's basically the torque developed at the armature, yeah. And then the shaft torque is the torque at the shaft. So I guess how do I explain this better? Okay, so the idea is that this one, if this is your motor, basically your input, if this is the machine, if this is the machine, your input comes from an electrical source here at the terminals. This is basically the terminals of the machine. And then, this is basically your electrical source supplying your machine, this whole machine. Now, it takes this electrical input through these terminals. This is where your VT will be, now subtract the losses, the electrical losses due to the armature being made up of copper. It's basically subtracting the voltage drop due to the copper. You get the voltage at the armature. So that is basically the voltage at the armature. That is the voltage developed here in this armature. That is basically the voltage, the power, that is where your power developed. Because in some literature, it is coined as power at the air gaps. Now, you subtract the mechanical losses, you get the power output of the shaft. So, since your shaft is basically the same at the power developed and the power power output, so you basically have the same RPM for that. However, you have different powers. Therefore, somewhere there is a variable that changed because of the loss, and that variable is your torque. So what happens here, if you look at the power flow, since you have the same shaft for, well, you have only one shaft for your machine, it is basically spinning at the same RPM. So the difference would be at the torque because of the power loss. So your power loss will manifest as a loss in torque. So when we say armature torque, that is basically the torque here at the armature, at the converted power. When we say shaft torque, that is basically the torque at the output. So yeah, that's armature and output torque, or shaft torque, output torque. And then field excitation, I have discussed this before. What more? Yeah, I guess that's it for motors, because it's basically the same as generators. It's just opposite in operation. And then later on, I'll be discussing speed control and other voltage control for generators, speed control for motors. Then the effect of what do you call this, saturation curve. The effect of the saturation curve, I'll be including that. Then output characteristics for motors, generators, and yeah, that's it. So yeah. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video.